Heat Wave. Right now, we are ready for our first match. It is scheduled for one fall. Now coming down to the ring, weighing in at 215 pounds from Detroit, Michigan, he is one half of Suicide Solution. Here is Biohazard.
Okay, wrestling fans, this is Eddie Apple subbing for the on assignment Sean Miller, and I want to thank Mr. Mike Ripple, my broadcasting colleague, for calling us here. First match, we're waiting for Biohazard, a former IWA World Tag Team Champion, of course, the Big C and Deever, here today in singles competition, and she's going to face one of my personal favorites, the spectacular youngster here in the International Wrestling Alliance, I'll Be Dan. I'm sure Mikey's going to tell you all that here in just a minute, being a broadcast journalist and all. I'll Be Damned, one of the more spectacular performers here in the sport of professional wrestling. A very airborne attack, I'm sure you're going to see from I'll Be Damned. Matt Maniacs, I'm glad to be back here on this presentation of Heat Wave. See, I'll be making his way down towards the ring. I'll Be Damned, of course, a member of the IWA Pro Wrestling School here in Columbus, Ohio, where he learned some of the fantastic tricks I'm sure you're going to see later on in this match. He's going to have his work cut out for him with Biohazard, is a very sneaky individual. Hey, Mike, glad to have you back here in the broadcasting booth.
I tell you, Eddie Apples, it's great to see you here instead of Sean Miller. As I understand, he's on some type of special assignment. My sources have told me it's some Beanie Baby sale going on. But in any event, I'm glad that you're here.
Well, knowing Sean the way we know Sean, wouldn't surprise me if he's not out scouting talent down on East Main Street here in Columbus, Ohio.
I know what you mean.
Instead of showing up here like he should and calling the matches. And what a spectacular match to start out this week's presentation of Heat Wave. I'll Be Damned versus Biohazard.
And what a great match this is. Yeah, Biohazard, one half of Suicide Solution, also a former IWA Tag Team Champion. He's in singles competition this week, and I haven't seen too many matches where Biohazard is wrestling as a single competitor.
Well, look at this, Biohazard, that choke, and right in front of the referee. Of course, referee Bud Hatter is going to call for an automatic break. Actually, what he should do here is force Bio to totally relinquish control, but he did make him break that chokehold. Into the ropes goes Biohazard.
Look at that. Nice move by I'll Be Damned. And I thought he was going to go for the cover. Obviously not.
Oh, not Albie. He's going airborne for some. Look at that. What a maneuver by I'll Be Damned. And I think, Mike, here, what we're going to see in this here particular confrontation is a clash in styles, if you will. You have the airborne. Whoa, there's a low blow.
It was that trick leg of his, I guess.
Yeah, that's going to take a lot of steam out of I'll Be Damned. They sure the referee caught that. Look at that. What a suplex by Biohazard, and that's something you don't expect to see from Biohazard or his tag team partner, the real deal, and that's scientific wrestling. We're still over here.
And a cover, and doesn't go for the cover. I thought he was going for the cover there.
Looking for some support from the fans here in attendance.
Well, Biohazard now going upstairs. I think he's wasting some time here.
It's strange, you know, just exactly what we thought wasn't going to happen is happening here. Biohazard showing some acrobatic ability going up top, and he was also using quite a few wrestling holds. I was about ready to say this is going to be the brawling ability of Biohazard versus the flying ability of Albie. Quick rollover by I'll Be Damned.
Well, Biohazard more of the extreme wrestling format, if you will, and I'll Be Damned more of the high-flying wrestling ability, and definitely a clash here on this week's edition of Heat Wave. And both competitors circling the ring. Now arm and collar, elbow and collar tie-up sends I'll Be Damned to the corner.
Get it straight there, Mike. I've been working with Sean Miller these past few weeks and probably eroded your skills.
I tell you, I have to keep my eye on him so he doesn't mess with the equipment and also try to pay attention on what's going on in the ring.
Well, now Sean Miller, an interesting character, as is his Biohazard. You know, Biohazard reminds me a lot of WWF star Mankind. Look at that drop kick by I'll Be Damned.
Nice drop kick and sends Biohazard to the outside of the ring. Oh, here comes I'll Be Damned.
Suicide dive connects.
Up and over right on Biohazard.
Looks like Albie's hurting himself. He's rolling, reading in agony here. As I was saying, Bio reminds me a lot of, look at that, that was smart, broke that count up real quick. Reminds me of an into the pole.
Oh.
Wicked, wicked pole shot right there by Biohazard. He reminds me a lot of what we're going to see here. Once again, breaks up the count. He's going up on top of that rail, dives right, oh my goodness.
What a maneuver by Biohazard going off of that steel bar and now dragging I'll Be Damned back into the ring.
Well, that was about a 5-foot drop, and you can see Bio get it right up and throw Albie into the ring. What I was trying to get out here is he reminds me, Cactus Jack, that he does not sense pain. This guy likes to hurt himself. The more you hurt him, the stronger he becomes.
Oh, yeah, he enjoys that. Cover one, two, and a kick out by I'll Be Damned. Another cover, one, two, and I'll Be Damned kicks out again.
And you know, the fact that Biohazard doesn't really deal with pain too well, or maybe deals with it extremely well, might prove to be Albie's downfall. Albie, no doubt the better athlete, but how do you beat a guy that's impervious to pain?
One, two, oh! He got the cover.
Well, no sooner said than done. Your winner of this match is gonna be Biohazard.
Here's your winner, Biohazard!
You had to tell the fans that, didn't you? Matt Maniacs, don't go away. We're gonna be back with more IWA wrestling action right after this. Boys and girls, age 8 through 18, this is your opportunity to become part of the fun and exciting world of big-time professional wrestling. Learn the holds and the counter holds of professional wrestling, be seen on local television, and amaze all your school friends. Don't miss this big opportunity. Call today for an absolutely free pro wrestling tryout. Okay, fans, we're back here on Heat Wave, and we're awaiting the arrival of a certain Columbus, Ohio radio DJ for Terry time. We heard the challenge last week. It looks like Bull Miller has someone. I don't know if this is the DJ in question. Hey, this guy's got a mask on.
Well, well, well. Look what the cat threw him in.
Could this be him?
Jackass.
Uh-oh. Serious words there by Terry Stellato.
You know, it's really easy to suck on your little microphone in your studio, running your mouth. I gotta give you credit, though. You showed up. But what the hell's with the mask?
Well, to tell you the truth, I just think I got a face for radio. Think too ugly to be here. And these people, well, you know, they paid their good money. I don't want them to see an ugly face like mine.
Well, that's
Thank
true.
You.
Don't take a real good looker to be on radio.
I got one more question before I stomp a hole in your ass. You know, my God, the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. You sure? Are you sure you're ready for this, man?
Are you calling me soft? Well, it seems to me that professional wrestlers are overweight, undereducated slobs.
Watch it.
Radio DJs are the only real men in this world. That's why we can say what we want, when we want, about who we want. I am an athlete.
You know, maybe you've eaten a lot of pizza and taken a shit for getting to wipe your ass makes you an athlete. Maybe you'd be a heavyweight champ. You know, for a dumpy little bastard, you sure got a big mouth.
Looks like this certain radio personality, Jimmy Jerk, I believe he's identified as, is trying to attack Terry Stellato here on Heat Wave. Hey, Mikey, glad to have you back in the broadcast booth.
Is that the best that this radio station has to offer?
Well, they said radio station DJs are the only true athletes. They took a hike real quick. Bat Maniacs, don't go away. That referee Bud Hattery counted him out. I think this is over, Mike.
It's over. The fat lady's going to sing. Or the fat man in this case.
Yeah, let's hope he don't talk. He did have a face for radio. I saw him backstage.
Here's your winner, Terry Stellato.
Well,
there's Stellato beating Jimmy Jerk. I believe he was announced that.
All right, fans, our next matchup is scheduled for one fall. Now coming down to the ring, weighing in at 200 pounds, here is Rip Romeo.
Okay, wrestling fans, Rip Romeo coming down to ringside. Very exciting young competitor here in the International Wrestling Alliance. He's scored some very impressive wins here in the last few months, and we're looking for some stiff competition for him here today on Heat Wave as he squares off against the Coyote. Of course, the Coyote, a member of Power Team USA, a very rough, tough individualist, and Rip, who has a little bit of an attitude problem, I think he's going to find that somewhere during the course of this match, he's going to raise the ire of the Coyote. You can see Rip Romeo flexing for some of the fans here in attendance. Better order one of those Charles Atlas courses there, buddy.
And his opponent, weighing in at 280 pounds from Phoenix, Arizona, the Coyote.
Well, as I said, Coyote, a member of Power Team USA. He's a big, strong heavyweight here in the International Wrestling Alliance. He's about 260. He's certainly going to have the weight advantage here in this particular contest. But don't count Rip Romeo out, because he's a very fast individual. He's very clever. And I wouldn't be surprised at all if Rip doesn't pull something out of the bag that may allow him to slip by the Coyote. Of course, the Coyote in the IWA Heavyweight Championship Tournament, which is presently going on. Coyote winning his match in the opening round of the tournament versus the Atomic Rhino. And of course, while this match has no bearing on that tournament at all, the last thing the Coyote wants to do is suffer a defeat here, right here on television. Now, Mike Ripple making his way back down towards the broadcasting booth.
Is that the best that that radio station has to offer? I mean, Jimmy Jerk, let me just tell you this. I just got back from the dressing room area. Jimmy Jerk, let me tell you this. You're better off staying in that little studio of yours, sitting behind that mic, spitting all over it, eating your pizza, and collecting your baby dolls. Just follow my advice. Don't come near a wrestling ring. You don't have the body for it. You definitely don't have the talent for it. You got that?
Now, hold on, Mike. Now, you know, and I know, that the characters of Jimmy Jerk and the Morning
Flu
are purely fictitious. I can't even say it. They're purely fictitious. And any resemblance between any morning crew on any particular radio station in Columbus, Ohio, who may make fun of professional wrestling, is purely coincidental.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, let's get back to the match. We was talking about the Coyote here, who, of course, advanced into the semifinals, or advanced into the next round of competition. Oh, low blow by Rip Romeo. Coyote advancing in past the first round of competition in the heavyweight tournament when he defeated the Atomic Rhino. And now he's in here with this hard body. He likes to be called his hard body.
He is known as the hard body, Rip Romeo. From Muscle Beach, California, nice maneuver by Rip Romeo.
I'm sure that's something he learned up here at the IWA Wrestling School. What I was talking about, though, is even though this match has no bearing on the heavyweight championship tournament, what would happen should Rip Romeo pull off an upset and emerge victorious here in this contest? It certainly would, we almost saw the end of it right there, certainly would put something in the back of the mind of the Coyote.
Indeed, if this was a tournament or a championship tournament matchup, Coyote obviously would have been eliminated from the tournament. Rip Romeo, what a chop. Rip Romeo.
Should he lose? He hasn't lost yet.
Well, yeah, but
let's not jinx the man.
I'm just making a scenario. That's all I'm doing. If Rip Romeo would win, of course, he would advance in the tournament. And who knows? He could have become the next IWA heavyweight champion.
Well, you know, the IWA Championship Committee being very... this is out there. Being very quiet about it. Who all exactly is even in the tournament? I mean, me and you are employees here of the company. They won't even tell us. I do know that the tournament was originally supposed to be an 8-man, and now they're talking about maybe expanding it to a 10-man tournament before they go into the semifinals or the final rounds or what have you. And also, I do know, I got the word earlier on from the higher-ups, if you will, that due to the fact that we lost our lease here at the Desert Rose, and we're not going to be able to tape the championship matches down here that we're actually going to go on pause here for about a month and then pick the tournament up when we have a new location, because they want all these matches here on television where all the wrestling fans can see them.
That's right. To be fair to the fans, they're going to televise each of the matches involved in the heavyweight tournament, and I'm just anxious to see who the new heavyweight champion is going to be.
Oh, no doubt. We saw some of the great action that's already happened in this heavyweight championship tournament, and I guarantee you, when as the rounds go by and it gets closer and closer and closer, these guys are going to put forth a tremendous effort like we've never seen before to emerge IWA heavyweight champion. And what's so great about this tournament is that everyone's equal going in.
That's true. That's true. Everybody's on the same page. And a cover by Rip Romeo. And it looks like a kick out.
Well, once again, fans, I do want to apologize that we're not going to be bringing you the tournament matches week after week here. We are waiting till we find a new place to tape. I understand we're going to be running some classic matches over the next couple weeks until we find that new place. And it's all because the championship committee has said, hey, we want our wrestling fans to be able to see this entire tournament. We want to see all the individuals, and it's the only way to do it, and it's actually being done for our fans, so I'm sure they'll all understand, Mike.
That's right. Oh, what a maneuver by the Coyote. Eddie, as you say, we will be back here next week with a classic show, a look back at some of the matches that has happened here in the IWA in the past. A nice maneuver by Rip Romeo.
Hey, maybe they'll go back and show some of my all-time great performers here in the IWA. Remember the Giant Warrior?
Guy's
like 7 foot tall.
The Bad Boys?
The Bad Boys, Hurricane and Wrecker, definitely one of my favorites, one of the all-time great tag teams.
Sean Casey, Jesse Salica, I mean, the list goes on and on.
My personal favorite, Hollywood Hubie. Remember Hollywood?
Oh, yeah. Two, and a kick out by Coyote.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised if Hollywood didn't come back just for the heavyweight championship tournament.
Well, you never know. Anything can happen in this great sport. It's been proven time and time again. Oh! Standing drop kick by Rip Romeo. Coyote trapped in the corner. Looks like an Irish whip coming up. A reversal. Rip Romeo to the corner. And comes a Coyote with a chop.
That's a vicious chop. You know, I talk to a lot of the competitors. They always talk about the vicious chops of this Coyote. I'd have to put them on the same keel as maybe a Ric Flair or a Benoit as far as those chops. Speaking of devastating maneuvers, this could be it. Coyote hooks a leg, one, two, and three, and he's got him. He got him right here.
Mike, your winner, the Coyote.
Thank you very much. Mike, we're going to take a pause here if you're done talking, and we'll be back with more IWA Championship Wrestling action right after this.
All shapes and sizes, this is your opportunity to become part of the fun and exciting world of big-time professional wrestling. The International Wrestling Alliance, Ohio's own homegrown Major League Professional Wrestling organization, is offering you this unique opportunity. Call today for an absolutely free tryout.
Why do we want to wrestle?
Because we like to hurt people.
Okay, back here on Heat Wave, and in today's presentation, one of our first championship match tournament matches. You're going to see two of them here today on Heat Wave. Tommy Chill, who is another graduate of the IWA Pro Wrestling School. He's only been wrestling about 6 months or so now. How he got in the tournament, I don't know. Maybe, you know, someone owed him a favor or whatever. But he's going to have his work or his hands or whatever. He's going to have something cut out for him here today as he's going to face the former IWA heavyweight champion, Marcus Dillon. Marcus the Man-Child Dillon.
And his opponent, being accompanied to the ring by his manager, Mr. Wimpy Watson, weighing in at 260 pounds from the borderland, he is a member of the Riot Squad. Here is Man-Child Marcus Dillon.
Hey, I got it right. See, folks, wrestling fans, I know what's going on. I've been away for a little while. All the news here at the IWA for sure. And as we said, we saw what happened just last week here on Heat Wave. The Riot Squad, apparently led by Mr. Wimpy Watson, affectionately known as the Weasel, had decided that they're not going to take part in, as Wimpy Watson referred to it, the IWA Little Tournament. How However, the big bosses came out and told him that, yes, they will be taking part. At least Marcus Dillon will be taking part in the championship tournament. We don't know if any other members, Miller, Shank, Jordan, anyone else is going to be part of this tournament. But Marcus Dillon, they said, was the former champion, the last champion of note, according to the IWA. We all know what happened. He gave
when we won and how we won. And by the way, you made a big mistake. This is the man child, Marcus Dillon, the IWA Heavyweight Champion of the World.
Well, maybe a little premature. As I was saying, we all saw what happened. Marcus Dillon joining the Riot Squad, giving fellow Riot Squad member Bull Miller a courtesy pin. And, of course, as far as the IWA was concerned, they stripped the title of him right then and there. Then, oh, my God, what happened after that? The Riot Squad selling the championship belt to Luscious John Ellering in the corporate exchange. Hey, Mike, glad to have you back here in the booth. What about that? Do you remember that? Selling the belt to the corporate exchange. Now, I don't want to go too far into Luscious John's intellect, if you will. But, I mean, that wasn't the brightest move he ever made, buying the championship belt. He had to realize that, I mean, it wasn't the Riot Squad itself.
Well, I know that Luscious John Ellering doesn't have a mind for fashion, obviously, from what he wears down to the ring. At least I thought he had a mind for business, but that proved all wrong when he actually bought the World Heavyweight title from Wimpy Watson. I mean, what's wrong with this picture? Anybody who's anybody in this great sport knows you don't deal with the weasel. He's always out to get somebody, always out to cheat, lie, steal, whatever. And of course, Luscious John Ellering bought into it. And as I understand, I think Wimpy Watson threw in the Brooklyn Bridge in some swampland in Florida with that.
Oh, probably did, knowing the weasel, Wimpy Watson. Of course, Wimpy Watson, along with the whole Riot Squad, they're just so sure that any member of the Riot Squad can defeat anybody at any given time. They said, well, here's this, this sucker. The corporate exchange, and they sold him the belt, figuring out how, you know, the Riot Squad can get it back any time they want. They wasn't even going to take part in the tournament. You know, they just figured they'd wait for the champion, whoever it may be, and then they'd walk in and take the belt back. So,
I heard you kind of summarizing the fans and bringing them up to date on what's going on. And, of course, the higher-ups here in the International Wrestling Alliance forced Wimpy Watson to have Marcus Dillon in the heavyweight tournament. And, of course, that's what you're seeing here now as he's going up against Hardcore Tommy Chill, as I understand, one of the students coming out of the IWA School of Professional Wrestling.
Well, he's actually been wrestling about 6 months now. I don't know exactly how he garnered a spot here in the championship tournament, but, you know, stranger things have happened in wrestling. Remember back, what was it, 1977, when Olympic boxer Leon Spinks defeated Muhammad Ali, and
yes.
Who would have predicted that to happen? You know,
that
the
is
greatest.
True.
Losing to Leon Spinks. Well, who knows? We got Marcus Dillon, the former champion, the guy who I used to refer to as the Phenom here in the IWA, simply because he came from out of nowhere in his first year and won the heavyweight championship belt. And, well, hey, we never know. We just may see a replay of that 1977 situation, and maybe this Hardcore Tommy Chill could defeat.
Well, nice splash by Marcus Dillon. Hardcore Tommy Chill in that corner, and I think that knocked the wind out of him. Irish whip. Hardcore to the ropes. Oh! And Marcus Dillon follows it up with the elbow.
That kind of looks like Leon Spinks in the second Ali Spinks fight at this situation at this point in time. Marcus going up on top for a high-risk maneuver. That's why they call him high-risk.
Fans, if you're just joining us, I'm here with Eddie Apples this week. As I understand, according to my sources, Sean Miller is on some type of an assignment. I'm hearing it's some type of Beanie Baby thing going on down at Kmart. So if you're down at Kmart, you'll probably see him there.
Oh!
Nice leg drop by Hardcore Tommy Chill. Cover. What is Shank Dorsey doing? I brought this up to Wimpy Watson when they were coming down to the ring. What is Shank Dorsey doing down at ringside? He doesn't have a manager's license.
Well, of course, you know, the entire Riot Squad is a very tight organization, but the combo of Marcus Dillon and Shank Dorsey seem to be particularly good friends, and they accompany each other several times. Devastating move by this big guy, this Hardcore Tommy Chill. Still couldn't get him. But, you know, despite the fact that Dillon and Dorsey are friends, you know, you're right. There's absolutely no reason for him to be at ringside. You don't have a license to be at ringside. And the referee should do something about that. definitely not a good situation for hardcore.
Definitely not. It's 3-on-1 when you have those guys down there. And Marcus Dillon fighting back.
Oh, low blow by Dillon.
Oh.
Well, I think we're seeing Tommy Chills is really in a... He's not in Marcus Dillon's class at this particular stage of the game. He's able to get this championship tournament match, and he's being outshined here by the former champion.
All right, Irish Whip sends Tommy Chill to the corner. He ducks out of the way just in time. Side Russian leg sweep.
I don't think it really had the effect on it should. It took Tommy Chill a little while to cinch in on that particular maneuver.
Oh, wait a minute. Whippy Watson up on the apron, and Dorsey in with the chair.
Dang Dorsey hitting Tommy Chill with his own chair.
And of course, the referee didn't see that.
Oh no, Wimpy Watson up there making sure the referee was distracted.
Here is your winner, the man child, Marcus Dillon.
Now there you go, Mike. And well, you know, that's a bad decision right there. The referee obviously didn't see what happened. Wimpy Watson getting up there, distracting the referee. Why the man child, Marcus Dillon, well, Shane Dorsey hit the man with the chair, and then Marcus Dillon discovered for the pin. That's the Riot Squad for you. Wrestling fans, don't go away. We'll be back right after this.
Father calls, says what's become of his son. A professional wrestler, just a no good bum. I said, dear dad, take back what you said, or I'll take you round to the shed and beat you till you're blood red. Cause wrestlers just wanna bust heads. Your life is hanging by a thread. Cause wrestlers just wanna bust heads. You better believe what I said. Cause wrestlers just wanna bust heads.
Look, we got all these bookings to do. We got Detroit the first night, then we got Chicago the next night. We got to be in New Orleans later on that week.
I know, Mike, but the Battens are going to be on one of those shows. They've got to fly them in from West Virginia. We've got to find some way to fit them in, get them for the show, but then we've
got
to fly them out.
Hey, I think you guys got some information for me.
You got to call Ringside Confidential to find out.
Come on, please.
Ringside Confidential to find out.
It's a free call. Call now.
All right, fans, our next matchup is scheduled for one fall, and it is in the Heavyweight Championship Tournament round. Now coming down to the ring, he is one half of Suicide Solution, weighing in at 245 pounds. Here is the real deal.
Okay, wrestling fans, this is our second championship tournament match here on today's presentation of Heat Wave, as Real Deal Dan Deever is coming down to ringside here. And the Real Deal, of course, a member of Suicide Solution. Yeah, there's Biohazard right there with him. The Real Deal's all psyched up for this match, knowing this is his opportunity to progress here in the championship match. And he's facing Rampage, who's a real tough competitor. I don't think actually we've seen him here on Heat Wave. Shows started here. However, I can tell you I've seen him several of the house shows that the IWA has presented, and he is a real tough, rough character, and he's going to take it right to the Dan Deevers. Deevers having a few words with one of our fans here. One of our fans trying to get up into the ring. His friend very wisely holding him back. I don't think you want to get into the ring with Big Dan Deevers. He's a mean individual. He hangs out with that psychopath, his partner. You see him up there, Biohazard. Biohazard is plain nuts. No other way of putting it. All right, let's cut this music. Let's get the intro on for Rampage. Come on, Mikey.
Opponent weighing in at 200 pounds, here is Rampage!
individuals who I don't really believe belongs here in the championship tournament. However, the powers that be, you know, the one who signed my check, said, yeah, he's going to be in and they threw him in here. The official word I've gotten is they are going to expand the championship tournament from an 8-man to a 10-man and possibly even a 12-man. And we're just going to wait to see what happens. All these individuals coming out here, striked up, Rampage. No different than any other professional wrestler, whether you've been wrestling for 6 months or 6 years. You want that. The same fans trying to get in here at Rampage. You hardcore wrestling fans, you fans of ECW maybe, I think you're going to like the style of Rampage because this guy's a, hey Mike, this guy's a nut, wouldn't you say?
Oh, most definitely indeed. Rampage and Real Deal. You know, the elevator doesn't go all the way to the top, per se, for these two guys. However, they're great. Great wrestlers in the ring, known for their hardcore style. And Rampage, a newcomer here in the IWA, is getting some experience with the Real Deal. And
what more experience can you ask for? This guy's a former World Tag Team Champion.
Exactly, exactly. And Rampage in with the splash.
You know, Mike, it's early in the tournament. You know, we're just finishing up the first round, but and it's a long, long way. We don't even know when we're going to be able to continue the tournament due to the problem of losing our lease at the Desert Rose. But would you care to hesitate to take a guess? I mean, with all the great professional wrestlers that's going to be in this tournament, who do you think, if you just had, if you had $10 laying around doing nothing, you want to put it down on a bet? Who would you bet on being the next IWA heavyweight champion?
Let's see, with all the talent that we have here in the IWA, I mean, that's, oh my gosh, there's so much talent. I'm going to take a wild guess and say Too Cool Trevor Lowe.
Too Cool Trevor Lowe? You know, that's another interesting situation. I don't even know where you came off with that one from, because we just saw, what was it, last week before, Too Cool Trevor Lowe being annihilated by Roadblock Max Mayhem, who was one of my early choices to win the tournament. How Too Cool was able to pull off an upset, I don't know. But,
well, of course, if Sean Miller was here, he would object to that 110%. I mean, in his mind, but little of it there is, he believes Too Cool Trevor Lowe doesn't even belong in the tournament. But being the true broadcast journalist that I am with the experience, I'm going to have to go with Too Cool Trevor Lowe.
Uh-oh, excuse me, Mike. I'm just kidding.
That was cute.
Just kidding. You know, if Sean was here, I'm sure he'd go with Marcus Dillon, because, you know, Sean's probably the biggest fan of the Riot Squad. Me, personally, I'm going to take an outside chance. I think the winner of the tournament, when it comes right down to it, is going to be Big Country. Big Country's really showed me a lot here recently. He's winning all the matches left and right, and I just can't see anyone really defeating him at this point in time.
Well, you know, having the heavyweight title around his waist would look good with that dress that he has to wear to the ring.
Oh, hey, speaking of dresses, or dressing or undressing, what do we got going on here?
Well, he just took off the belt that belongs to Rampage, and I bet you that, yeah, he's going to use it as a foreign object.
Yeah, you know, that's that teaming with Biohazard coming through there. Dan Deaver's a very technically sound wrestler, but he's got that mentality, that Biohazard mentality.
Nice reversal of the Irish whip. In comes Rampage.
And I'm getting a message here over my headset. You hear that, Mike?
Hello.
You hear that?
I think mine is off.
What are you hearing? I just got the message here on my headset that the match has been signed for later on here in the program. We are going to see the Casanova Clique squaring off against the Riot Squad contingency of Maniac Mark. We haven't seen him around forever. But
Shank Dorsey and Marcus Dillon.
Oh, the bell's ringing. What's going on here is... Are we seeing a disqualification? It should be. These two individuals in here, suicide solution.
The bell has sounded.
Mikey, we got to find out what's going on here.
Here is your winner by disqualification, Rampage.
I can't believe it. Rampage has won this match. Wrestling fans, I just got the news on my headset. As I said, we're going to see the Casanova Clique squaring off against the Riot Squad here in today's main event. Now, from what I understand, the Click is asked for this match because of the situation where they got to wear dresses. Chip Ogden feels that he shouldn't wear a dress because, or he shouldn't have to wear a dress because of his partner in the corporate exchange, the parent group of the Casanova Click, if you will. And the man I just said is going to win the heavyweight championship of the world, Big Country, lost that match, which is forcing them all to wear dresses. And I understand the stipulation for this match is, should the Casanova Click emerge victorious, then they won't have to wear a dress. Wrestling fans, don't go away. We'll be back with more action right after this. Go get them, Mike.
All shapes and sizes, this is your opportunity to become part of the fun and exciting world of big-time professional wrestling. The International Wrestling Alliance, Ohio's own homegrown Major League Professional Wrestling organization, is offering you this unique opportunity. Call today for an absolutely free tryout.
Why do we want to wrestle? Because we like to hurt people.
Okay, back to action here. Matt, fans picking this one up in progress, if you will. You're seeing Damien Kass from the New Breed and Sexy C.
Sexy C, a fairly newcomer here in the International Wrestling Alliance. Oh my gosh, what a chop. I tell you, this young guy really does show lots of talent in the ring. Has come a long way, a student in the IWA School of Professional Wrestling.
You know, Mike, this kid's actually in, I call him a kid, he's 17 years old. He's actually in the youth class of the IWA Pro Wrestling School, and he went out on his own, went behind the IWA back, if you will, or the school's back, got himself professional matches in some other leagues. And even though the school was against it, you know, they said, hey, the kid's already out there, he's wrestling, and he begged, if you will, to get his spot here in the IWA, Ohio's own Major League Professional Wrestling organization.
That's right.
And hey, the powers that be said, well, the kid's wrestling already, so let's do it. And they're letting him take a shot, and he's getting a little bit hardcore, so he goes out into the audience, and I think this is, what, his second appearance here on Heat Wave.
Well, that's true. Sexy C definitely paying his dues here in the IWA, going up against Damien Kass, and Damien Kass is throwing him around like a rag doll. Kass on the top rope and just comes down and levels Sexy C.
Well, it just amazes me that a 17-year-old youngster can even participate in a grueling sport like professional wrestling. And against an individual like Damien Kass, who's been around a few years now, a very crafty individualist for sure. And, you know, it's not take a whole lot away from Sexy C. He's got some great moves, and that's what garnered his position here in the professional ranks of wrestling.
That holy face, Damien Kass, that did, and Sexy C is just trying to fight back with everything that he has.
Now let's talk a little bit about Damien Kass's situation. I mean, a member of the New Breed before the defection of Marcus Dillon, and then Trevor Lowe discovering that he's too cool. He goes out on his own as well. Hey, look at this Sexy C, he's going up on top. This can't be happening here.
This is a high-risk maneuver. Oh my gosh.
Nailed him for sure. That's going to take some starch out of Damien Kass. Damien Kass going down to the second level floor here.
Well, Eddie, you received a message through your phones, and I received a memo regarding the matchup coming up here on Heat Wave. The Casanova Click taking on Shank Dorsey and Marcus Dillon. Of course, the Click is going to have to wear dresses during this match. I tell you, that should be amusing.
Well,
very amusing.
That's for sure. Oh, look at that. That wasn't very amusing. This youngster, you know, not to second guess the powers that be here in the IWA, but the ECW recently ran into some trouble, some big trouble, by allowing a minor 17-year-old to compete. But, you know.
Well, as I understand, Sexy C did sign an agreement to waive all rights in case he was injured due to his age. That shows you how desperate Sexy C is in getting into that ring and just getting that mat experience.
Well, no doubt, and even though he hasn't been on too many of the winning sides of the stick here since his professional debut, this kid's 17 years old, and who's to tell where he's going to be 10 years from now if he's able to stick with it.
Well, that is true. Anything can happen. And all that just happened. Damien Kass kicking Sexy C in the midsection. Takes him up. He'll cover one, two, three.
Well, Mikey got him right there, and it's another L in the book for Sexy C. But like I said, don't count this young kid out, because I see him up at the IWA Wrestling Gym on youth night and on the older folks' nights, and he gives it his all every time, and I'm predicting a future stardom here for Sexy C. Fans, don't go away. We'll be back with more action right after this.
Father calls, says what's become of his son? A professional wrestler, just a no-good bum. I said, dear Dad, take back what you said, or I'll take you round to the shed and beat you till you're blood red. Cause wrestlers just wanna bust heads. Your life is hanging by a thread, cause wrestlers just wanna bust heads. You better believe what I said, cause wrestlers just wanna bust heads.
Boys and girls, aged 8 through 18, this is your opportunity to become part of the fun and exciting world of big-time professional wrestling. Learn the holds and the counter holds of professional wrestling, be seen on local television, and amaze all your school friends. Don't miss this big opportunity. Call today for an absolutely free pro wrestling tryout. Okay, wrestling fans, the year was 1982, 2 years before the birth of Hulkamania. Hulk Hogan wrestling Jerry the King Lawler in the Mid-South Coliseum. Check out how this one ended. I'm sure the Hulk don't want you to see. And check out who was the Hulk's manager.
Strategy man. And Lawler sidestepped him and threw him in. Up on the ring turnbuckles.